suppose they're ready at the back. Already at the back, guys? Cool, if we're ready at the back, we'll kick off with Gary from Sky Sports.
Hello, Mikel.
Hello.
Thank you for your time. Can we have any injury updates, please, particularly William and Eddie?
William is still not available. He's progressing well, and we are hopeful that we're going to have him available in the next few weeks, but we have to see. And Eddie's back. Eddie's fully fit now, and he's back.
So he's available for selection?
Yes.
And with William, sorry, but we didn't see him training at the Open training earlier in the week. Is he yet back on the grass or not yet?
He's not far. We're starting to do that. Obviously, we need to be cautious because of the injury, but he's evolving well.
A lot of the players were seen to be very, very upset by that late goal that Liverpool scored. Are you pleased that they're that upset?
Yeah, we should be. When you concede in the last few minutes, you have to be upset because we wanted to win the game. But then as well, we have to be realistic and we have to accept that we have an exceptional period in the first half where we should have killed the game. But the reality is in the second half, we have really tough moments that we have to dig in, and now we should have conceded a few goals as well. So that was the game.
And you say things like, for example, you know how you feel now, we need to stop that happening again.
Yeah, after the game, it's easy to say stop happening. We try to prevent that in many moments against them, and we actually did it because they're going to have periods of dominance, periods where they get you into that chaotic game that they're exceptional at, and we didn't manage to get out of that game well enough, and that's what we suffer.
Is luck, among other things, going to be a factor in the run-in to the title?
You need luck. You need luck in the right moment. That luck, why that luck is coming from, I think is really important, and how you think about it and what is going to happen. But yeah, it's another part in the sports. Sometimes it's about inches, and those inches have to go your way.
Luck's a factor, obviously. Fitness is going to be a factor, potentially tiredness as well. Manchester City involved in three competitions still. I know it hurt when you went out of Europe, but are you now able to reap the benefits of just being able to concentrate on the Premier League?
We want our players to be as fit as possible and available, and we have certain issues, especially the last few months, with some important players, and we just want to have everybody available and fit at their best to help the team.
Are you any good at maths?
I'm quite good.
The boffins at Opta have used percentages wizardry to work out the possibility of who's, or the probability of who's going to win the Premier League, and they say it's Man City.
Well, when you asked them at the start of the season, for sure it was like this. So nothing has changed.
Thanks. We'll go to Anita from the Premier League.
Hi, Mikel.
Hi.
Just continuing on where you are, if you go back to the beginning of this season, did you envision 2.5 years under your belt with Arsenal that with 8 games to go in this campaign you would be fighting for the title?
Yes.
Really?
You go day by day, honestly. There is so much that happens every single day, every month in a football club that you cannot really look. Obviously, the aim and the moment that I took the job was to bring that club back to where it belongs, and it's fighting and being around every single trophy that is possible at the highest level. And that's what we are trying to do.
Are you ahead of schedule, given that you are?
We are where we are. We are happy where we are, and now we have to finish the job. And in order to do that, it's going to demand an extra bit for everybody.
You ask so often about Bukayo Saka, deservedly so, and you give praise to all your players, but I wanted to ask you about the evolution of Martinelli this season. He is the club's leading goal scorer, 14 goals compared to just 6 last season. What do you think has been key to that, and also how important is he in the way Arsenal are playing this season?
Well, he's playing more games, that's for sure. He's got another year of experience. He's got huge understanding now with his teammates. The way he approaches every single session, the way he approaches his training, his life, is just to be the best. And when that happens, and you have the consistency that he has in how he deals with every situation every day, only good outcomes are going to be in front of him. And I'm not surprised about that. And the good things are still a lot of things to improve.
Successful on the road in London derbies this season. West Ham at the weekend, they're fighting for survival, just 3 points above the relegation zone. What kind of game are you expecting, and are you surprised at all by where they are on the table?
Very difficult game. We know we've been there a few times, and we always find really tricky and difficult games. I know David really well and how he's going to prepare the game as well, and we are ready. It's going to be a fight. It's going to be another big derby for us, and we're going to have to be at our best to win it.
Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Good to Ian from TalkSport.
Hi, Mikhail. How are you?
Very good.
You mentioned there you know David Moyes really well. Can you just talk about the respect you have for him? Because obviously you played for him at Everton. You signed for him.
I think more than respect, I think is admiration. I love playing under him. I would go through a brick wall for him when he was my manager. I think everybody would in that squad. Really good coach, exceptional at managing the group and dealing with individuals. And then a very special person, a really special human being, very trustworthy. And a man who honors his word, and he always did it, and someone that I learned a lot from.
People always ask you what you learned from Pep Guardiola, and you must have learned loads under him. Was there things you learned in particular off of David?
Yeah, he saw things in me that I didn't know, and he asked me to play in positions they never played in my life. The way he challenged me, but at the same time, the way he gave me support, love, and care, it was the right balance, and is what I needed, and he got the best out of me. So really, really, really helpful.
Aaron Ramsdale was outstanding last Sunday. You got some, not from within or from within the club, but with Arsenal fans on social media, some people questioned when you signed him, why you needed to sign him. He's been brilliant for you this season. Is he one of the main reasons you're challenging for the title?
Well, you need, obviously, individuals to perform at the highest level, and certainly you need your keeper to be very present in certain moments. And you see every team that has won titles, the goalkeeper is just a key contributor to that. And Aaron's been really, really good this season.
And finally, City played before you. A, when you watch it, and B, do you leave it down to your individual players whether they want to watch it? I mean, we know Ben White's not a great watcher of football outside of when he plays. I mean, will the players be allowed to watch it?
Yeah, we are there. We will watch it like we watch many other Premier League games.
Very good.
Thank you.
Jordan, the Athletic.
Mikhail, your one experience of winning a title as a player came at Rangers. I know it was 20 years ago, but when you think back to what it was like in those final 2 months, what lessons did you learn, and are you bringing some of those experiences now?
The same that when I was at other clubs and we were fighting for trophies is to stick to what you do every single day, be the best as you can be every day, and never give up, because there's always another opportunity, there was another moment, and especially in football you have to be ready when that opportunity comes in.
I know we spoke about what you learned from David Moyes, but Alec McLeish, when you're speaking about being emotionally sound and taking day by day, game by game, what does that actually look like? And environment, how do you do that?
Talking about it, demanding that to each other, and creating an environment that nothing is more important than actually what's going to happen today. And when that happens, everybody understands that you are present in the moment, and that's what you can control.
I know you said luck could be a factor, and there might be a matter of inches in it, but goal difference could also potentially be a factor. It's not too difficult to imagine it coming down to that. Is that something that you're beginning to think about?
We think about every possibility, and obviously we want to win matches first and earn the right to win it, and then obviously we want to score as many goals as possible, but you have to be open to every single possibility.
If you go 2-0 up early in a game, are you prepared to go all out attack to try and maximise the potential of that game?
Every game is a different story.
Okay, we'll go to Kai from Football London.
Hi Mikhail, I just want to take you back to a couple of years ago, the 3-3 draw at the London Stadium. You said it was a game that was going to give you nightmares. Are they coming back ahead of this match?
Well, there were certain lessons that we had to learn from that game, especially the way we started the game, but as well what we did afterwards, and probably for the supporters or the viewer, it was a great game to watch. But yeah, they have this capacity to take the game into a scenario that becomes a little bit like that, and obviously we won a different game.
And you said as well that your team had two faces at the time, whereas now they seem much more consistent. What's changed over what is a relatively short space of time?
Well, the word that you use, consistency. You know, in every ball that we play, the approach that we have in every scenario, in every area away or home game that we play, that's why we are where we are, because we've been consistent. We've been performing at the highest level for many months right now, and that's something that before we didn't do.
We'll go to Mark.
Sorry, Martin Odegaard, obviously that was a real him that day. Was that sort of the day when you decided this guy is future captain material at Arsenal?
Not, but obviously that was a game that that took probably his status to a different level, because the game that he played, especially in the context that the game was in that period, and as well, I think it gave him a huge boost of confidence as well to him to understand how good he is and how he could contribute to the team.
Okay, Mark from Pierre.
Hi, Miguel. Alex looked visibly upset when he came off last week at Anfield when he was sat on the bench. So I just wondered what his reaction has been like in training this week, and is it the kind of reaction you'd expected from someone who's been around a month?
Really good, no problem.
He's been okay?
Yeah.
And then I know at the home game earlier this season was the first time that Arsenal actually came back to the Emirates, and you said it was a perfect moment for that. Have you found yourself maybe seeking his counsel a bit more at this stage of the season? He's been there and won things before. Do you find you talking to him more or anything like that at the moment?
No, there was obviously that have wanted brought something different to the team. They have experienced those moments. They know that's here and the context and the opposition that we play against that you need to seek for excellence and it has to be perfect. And it has to be perfect in everything you do to really earn the chance to be there. And then another thing is to win it. And now we are there and now we have to win it. So we have to be exceptional at everything that we do.
Okay, we'll go to 10:30 tonight now. Mark?
You just go back to Aaron Ramsdale.